Hi, this is Linda, and I've been reading about these two young boys from Chechnya that are now considered the bombers, and I hear that Boston's pretty much under martial law. I see that they converted to Islam. He wouldn't take his shirt, one of them wouldn't take his shirt off because respect for women and other things. Wow. They didn't sound very fundamentalist Islam, although they were sympathetic to Al-Qaeda. But if you go to Wikipedia and look up Al-Qaeda, Al-Qaeda means the base, and it was started by the United States government. So Al-Qaeda, if they're sympathetic to Al-Qaeda, in a way they're sympathetic to the American terrorists that we push around other countries and create havoc. So I just don't see. I have a 20-year-old, and I just, for the life of me, do not believe. I think these are patsies, like we use all kind of patsies. They couldn't have pulled this together without someone in an upper alphabet agency. You know, it could be from another country, I don't know, doing this. But I'm going to say they're the patsies, and it makes me damn mad that this is what we're doing now. And also, I'd like to say something about the Islam, Muslim, all this thing, the fundamentalist part of this, because they're using this Muslim, Islam reference. I'm Native American, half Native American, half white. I choose the red road. I went to a very fundamentalist cult church called the Catholic Church because I was forced to. They beat the hell out of my hands with rulers. It was nothing but control and beat the savage out of me until they actually expelled me and I got to go live back with the Native Americans. So I was not controllable, and I believe in the more spiritual realm rather than there's some big man, because they seem to place God as a man. This man gave birth to the universe. This makes no sense if you start connecting the dots. So I just am not buying this Muslim fundament. I don't even see him as fundamentalist. And actually, I'm going to stop the labeling. They're two young boys who are being patsies for some alphabet agency, probably the CIA or some ghost or FBI. The FBI seems to fumble up more than anybody at this point. Or Homeland Security, I'm not sure. Now, what are we going to do? They're going to get the Russians and the Chechenians hating us, and we're going to divide the world more when we need to be pulling together. I'm going to briefly say something on the, I think a lot of it's a distraction, but there's going to be one of the children is dead and there'll be another one. You know they'll kill them. We'll never get the story. That's what we do as an empire. Now, this is what I'd like to say. There is an immigration bill passing, and a lot of people are angry about it. And if the immigration bill is the ones about the illegal Hispanics here in the United States of America, I would call them refugees at this point for what we have done to them along their border, where Eric Holder should be in jail for all this. I mean, the chaos caused in Mexico, what else can they do but flee someplace else? And they're not taking American jobs. They're really not. America has no jobs. And I would rather give money, my taxpayer money, which is voluntary anyway, to help humanity than to fund these stupid wars and kill other human beings. So that's just my take. You can argue with me if you want. I'm not going to argue back. I love everyone. Humanity's got to pull together. We've got to stop the division. And I will say one thing. I'm from the South, and some of my friends who are fundamentalist Christians said they had no tolerance for me no more because I'm Native American. And that when the Civil War comes, people like me will probably be outed. So your fundamentalist Christians are now kind of speaking a little dangerously, you know, because I'm Native American and haven't been saved by Jesus. Well, I don't believe that way, but I still respect those people, and I just wish I could get the same respect back. But anyway, I love you all. I think this is a false flag, and if you can't connect the dots on that one, these are young boys. I have a 20-year-old. He'd have never in his life been able to pull something like this together. So I love everyone. Peace, love. No fear. Let's hope we can get through this before these people who run the empire destroy the whole earth.